Replay, which I made in 2000, is a three-screen installation that features also a book called La Guerre du Liban, Images et Chronologie, published by Dar El Masira. It's one of the first books that show some of the images, very hard images about the war. For many years, I had this idea of doing an installation. I only realized it when I was invited by Ashkal Alwan to be part of a show called Hamra Street Project. The idea around it was to show some works in public spaces in the former cinemas in Hamra. Slowly, I realized that I had been away from Lebanon for many years, and that Hamra, if I was to think of Hamra Street Project, if I was to think of the street Hamra, this was the place where my father had an office during my childhood. And my childhood was completely related to the war. It was impossible to differentiate my childhood from the war. There were two ideas. One was to reflect on the war, and the second one was to reappropriate myself a territory that I had been displaced from. And so I started to think about this installation called Replay. The first inspiration came from two images that had haunted me for years. For years, while I was in Paris, I had this book published by Dar El Masira, La Guerre du Liban, Images et Chronologie, with one image was actually a set of three images showing a man fallen on the ground while being shot. So he was photographed while being shot, or shot while being photographed. And the other image, a woman barefoot, screaming in the street, showing really she was in despair. And these two images haunted me, and I didn't know what to do with them. And then when I was invited to do that show, I thought, I want to work on this idea of using these two archival images. The idea came from a very simple thought. If I see a man falling in the street, why do I feel that or think that maybe he's dying? A banal, very banal act, a man falling in the street. And I thought it's maybe because that man had already fallen, not just in the image, but in other histories, in other geographies, and will fall again. So I started to think about this idea, working on the concept of non-linear time. There's no more like past, present, and future. Although the image that inspired me is an image from the past. Another work that inspired me, but I only understood it later, was Chris Marker, La Jetée, where the past and the present and the future are all become all this non-linear time. What if that image of the man falling is an instant of violence, a rupture of time? This idea of instant of violence, instant of rupture, also triggered another thought. What happened before the photographer has taken these images? I start to imagine that what may have happened was a projection, my own projection, onto that photographic instant. And I asked two performers, they were not real performers in life, they were friends. I asked two performers to reenact the instant that I had imagined and to repeat it. And so we took many takes. I reconstituted as close as possible with my little means the setting of both photographs. So there is a man that keeps falling. I repeat in loop this fall. And there is a woman that keeps running towards the camera as if she's constantly escaping something terrible. And the man is constantly falling as if always endlessly dying and then never dying really. And in the middle of the screen, I decided to have a shot of the sea being the place of irreversible rupture because it's uninterrupted, but it's always a rupture when the wave arrive on the shore. So it's of course a reflection on time and rupture. And the sea was the most interesting element that could be this body, this other body between these two vein bodies that are doing this vein action. When I think of Beirut, I can only think of this horizon of the sea. It's a very important. Beirut is at the central, is the center of all my work. And in that work, although you don't see the representation of Beirut, of course the setting of the two actions are in Beirut. And the sea is really represented horizon. The fact that it's endlessly repeated, of course, I shot in black and white. And because there are two archival images, I'm reenacting a projection of that I did on these archival images. At the end of the loop, which is 4:07, something like that, the screen, the left and right screen, the man and the woman become turned into color. To sort of as a reference, there's always this play also between the reality and maybe the non-real and the real, the archive, and the reenactment of the archive. The notion of repetition was something very interesting, because for me it was always repetition as a renewal, a repetition as a possibility, a process of creation and recreation. And of course, it created the lyricism and it engaged the viewer in the work. But for me, this is something that I continue to work on. So for instance, in the film that I've started at the same time of Replay, called Replay Bis, I use a short story that I wrote in a plane. I always thought it was a dream until I reached 25 and I realized this wasn't a dream. It was a story about an escape during the war. It was a story about fear during childhood. And what I did is I replayed that story three times within the 9 minutes of the film. Every time the story and the text acted differently. As a renewal, I also worked in other pieces, such as Sleep, for instance, where I filmed myself with my former partner sleeping, and where using a photogram with an intervalometer, I use that sequence shot, which is one night of sleep, and I repeated it, expanding it each time, renewing the shot until I reached also a video of 7 minutes, which is almost like a painting that transforms through time. Repetition is, of course, a means to reflect not just on the process of creation, but also on time and duration, something that is at the core of all my artistic practice. The first time I showed Replay in Hamra at the Colisée Cinema, I had taken the three images of the man and the photograph of the woman, transferred them on canvas and displayed them. Later, I understood that this was a bit gimmicky, and I didn't want that those archival images are aestheticized or even become an artwork by themselves being transferred on canvas. And I decided to show the book itself. It was very important to show the reference of the work. Although the videos, the three screen videos, are completely different than the original images, it was very important for me to have the book as a reference. I think it also confirmed the importance of archive, working with archive in my work in many different ways. Objects of War is an ongoing archive. It works on this idea of archaeology of the war by constituting an archive made of these multiple stories that are all subjective of the Lebanese wars. But there are other works, like in Replay Bis, I use my personal photographs from my family, but also anonymous photographs to create a fiction. But for instance, in my film on the disappeared, called Here and Perhaps Elsewhere, in Arabic it's Huna wa Rubbama Hunak, I crossed town, I crossed the city of Beirut for 3 weeks with a camera, without any preparation, following what used to be the Green Line. I asked the inhabitants that I encounter, do you know of anyone who was kidnapped here? Something very important, I used archival images from Es-Safir, from the former checkpoint, to punctuate my journey. So the archive here, the archival images from these former checkpoints and also passage point that divided Beirut were important, because I could confront them with the present time and see, like, not only what has changed and what has not changed, like the before and after, but it was almost a way to reenact the physical space and spot of these. For me, to walk was a performative action, to walk through the city and to find the location of this checkpoint where many people have been kidnapped. And later, in a journey, I used a lot of archival images from newspaper, but I also Super 8 footage from my family, integrating them to sort of like a web, like a spider web, mixing these found footage, archival images, and contemporary images that I filmed from my family to create a story that is fragmented, elliptical, that is as much where the personal meets the collective history of the region. So there was always a use of images. And finally, maybe one of the recent work where I use a lot of archive to the point that it's almost quotation, like I'm quoting through text and images, is Beirut Autopsy of a City. In Beirut Autopsy, I felt that it came out of a projection of an anxiety that was completely irrational, where between 2005 and 2010, I felt that Beirut could disappear, our experience of living in Lebanon could end. And then I started to dig in the history of Lebanon from 1200 BC until the future. It's a speculation from 1200 BC until 2058. And I started to dig and see all these moments where Beirut could have disappeared because of a tsunami, because of a tsunami and earthquake, because of a crusaders invasion, because of a bombardment by the British, because of a 1982 Israeli attack, etc. And I started to collect these images, some videos that I've done, but text by pilgrims, text by historians, etc. This was the first chapter of Beirut Autopsy, which used a lot of archival images from various sources, such as Arab Image Foundation and Nahar, Fouad Debbas collection, but also text by many authors.